Well, I've been using the pole lathe quite a lot now, and I've got a nice pile of shavings to prove the point. I've been making a few modifications which have been quite helpful. First of all, the actual treadle, I've made it a bit longer, so actually the top of the treadle where I tied the rope actually comes more or less up to centre height of the lathe. That seems to give a nice sort of purposeful action. I've also put a sort of boat cum climbers open closing hook on the rope for the pole lathe, just really so I can hook it on and off the bungee quickly, which is quite useful. And the bungee, I was surprised. I started off with a very thick bungee and found that took quite a lot of effort. And actually, all one needs to do is get a strong enough bungee to return your pedal. So I've actually now, I'm using a 6mm, quite a thin single 6mm bungee, and that's working fine. So I'll just hook this up. I've got a pole now to make it easy to hook up to the bungee. The other little modification is I've made the bungee height is about 6 feet above the lathe bed, and that gives a nice scope for stretch up and down. So it gives, I find this, you get a nice steady turning motion on this now, which really works very happily. Chisel wise, I've got a roughing chisel, which is made by Ashley Hills, British maker, very high quality, very nice ordinary carbon steel chisel, easy to sharpen and does a very nice finish. And then I've got one of their smoothing chisels, which is a large 2-inch skew type chisel. And again, that's very nice, just doing the smoothing off. And the only other chisel I'm using actually is about 3/4 inch, maybe 1/2 inch, no, more like 3/4 inch. Ordinary wood turner's skew chisel, which I use for doing the little beads on the Windsor chair legs. And that gets a nice bit of detail, it's easy to handle. I researched how many turns you can get on the actual bit of work you're turning, and it does vary quite a lot, but you need to be able to get about 5 turns, and you need to expect to see the treadle actually come up to the lathe bed and right down to the ground. I did hear a story about where one of the old bodgers actually dug a pit in his house at home so the treadle could actually go down into the pit as well, and he managed to do a bead turning on the chair leg for each sort of complete revolution down, which seemed quite clever, quite a good little story. So there you are, one lathe anyway in good working order now, and nicely tuned up for doing fast cuts.